If you've ever edited each of a presentation's 100 slides to change the font size, color, or style, then you need to know about the Slide Master. If slide titles or the company logo jumps around in position from one slide to the next, you need to meet the Slide Master. I'm Dawn Bjork, a Microsoft Certified Trainer and a Certified PowerPoint Specialist. Let's look at the Slide Master. This is a critical feature that's unknown to most PowerPoint users. During speaking and training engagements, typically only about 10% of all the participants are familiar with the Slide Master, and that's a huge loss in productivity. First, it may be helpful to know that every presentation has at least one Slide Master, whether or not you work with it directly. The Slide Master is a blueprint for your presentation, and it helps you to create a professional slide deck without a lot of effort. PowerPoint applies changes made to placeholders, background, color effects, fonts, positioning, and graphics. You kind of get it. Just about everything is on a master, which links to specific presentation slide layouts. Have you ever played around with different PowerPoint themes? For instance, in this presentation, if we wanted to change the look of the slides and the overall presentation, we could do so by going to Design. And here we have a variety of different themes. Now, most of these are built into PowerPoint. You'll find thousands of other options by going to File and New and searching for different themes. That is, you may not find a layout or a look that fits within the built-in choices. Just for example, if I wanted to select this design, notice how it changes everything about the presentation, the same content, but now we have a change to the color scheme, the fonts, the placement of the elements. And this particular theme also has color variations. You'll find these in the upper right-hand side of this design area under variants. Now, not every theme has this, although there is a colors place where you could actually pick custom color schemes to apply. So if I change to the blue one, notice how this overall transforms the look of this presentation. Or we could dig into a completely different design theme, which may or may not also have its own variations. Let's dig in now into the PowerPoint Slide Master and look at how you can work with it to save hours customizing the look of your presentations. As we just saw, when you make a change on your own Slide Masters, PowerPoint applies that change to every related slide in the presentation. Now, this saves you a lot of time and gives your presentation a consistent look and feel. But because of that, it's also good that you make sure that you make a copy of your current presentation simply so that you can experiment with some of these changes without dramatically or adversely impacting the look of your slides. Now, in this presentation, we have some consistency, but we also have a few issues with the look and layout, and I'll share with you how you can change these as well. Let's say in a slide we want to impact or change the title. The common approach is to simply come in and perhaps we'll make this bold and I'll make it red. If that's a look that you want to apply to the entire presentation, that would also mean that you would be manually moving to each slide and making this update. And this is one of the reasons why you want to know about the Slide Master. Instead of individually changing it, we can change it overall for the look of the presentation. To find the Slide Master, we'll go to the View tab. From there, you'll see that not only do we have different presentation views, such as the slide sorter, notes pages, but we also have master views. Here is the Slide Master. It may be also helpful if you use handouts or notes to explore that you can also customize those masters. From the Slide Master, now we see the behind the scenes. And I'll move up here to the top to see that this is the primary master that feeds into all of these other different layouts. Now, each presentation can look a little different. Really want to start at the very beginning here because it's going to be more work if you're working with an existing presentation and making these changes, especially with manual formatting. Sometimes the final product doesn't look anything like the layout that was used to build it. Let's go back to that title example. This is where we change the appearance. So for instance, I want to maybe make this bold. Notice that these colors are coming from the theme. You actually could pick any color that you want, but these are colors that are designed to work together. And so then you also have another place where you can be more consistent. I'll pick the green here. By making that change, this feeds into the other slides. Here, for instance, is the layout for our title slides or for our content slides, where we will typically put in bullets or add other PowerPoint elements. So see how these are connected. Now, a couple other things that you might want to consider. Let's add a logo. That would be under Insert, Pictures, and we navigate to where that logo is stored. In this case, I'll move the logo to the bottom right-hand corner, and this could also move to another corner or a location in the slides. Make that a little bit smaller. It's becoming more common not to necessarily show this on every single slide, but it is branding that some organizations like to have. And so often we'll see these placed individually on the slide, just jumping around because they're not in a consistent location. You might notice here too that this is carrying forward to a number of these different layouts, but not to our title slide. And that is on purpose. Although we might want to see the logo, there's often a lot of other things that are going on in the title slide. And so perhaps we want it in a different position, different size, or not at all because of other graphics that are part of this. Let's go ahead and see how these simple changes are impacting our primary presentation. Now, one of the things that can also happen in presentations too is a presentation can actually have multiple slide masters, especially if we're importing from different sources. So it could be on purpose or maybe not at all. But from here, I'll close the master view. And notice that this change that we make, the logo in the corner, that is displaying. However, because this was manually formatted, this title did not get updated as other changes were made. But it shows on other slides that were not manually formatted. So that's something that we'll look at. How can we fix it when the slides already have changes in it? Now here's one of the other things that can happen. Some slides just might have too much going on. So if we look, for instance, at putting that logo into the slide master, maybe that's something that we don't want to see because there's just already a lot of busyness. That is something that can be changed either in the slide master for individual layouts or for individual slides. Now, in this case, I'll go back to design, and on the far right-hand side is format background. From here, I'll choose hide background graphics. And so if you pick that, notice what happens to this slide layout. Those background graphics are not displayed, and now this helps us to focus only on that chart. And it's only for this individual slide. You would have that option as well to apply to the specific layouts. Let's look at those layouts for just a moment. Under Home, when we're working with a presentation and choose Layout for a new or existing slide, here are those slide layouts. So the names that display here are coming from the slide master. And this also is then what determines where these different elements will be, placeholders, and even the formatting for those titles. Let's move back to that slide master and just make a few other modifications to it. Once again, View, Slide Master, and perhaps I want to move that logo around a little bit and just move it down a little bit to the corner so it's not quite as intrusive. And I decided that I'd rather not have this be bold. So those are minor things, but once again, if this feeds into those slides, we only have to change it one time. Another element that might be helpful in the Slide Master is to determine whether or not you want to have a footer, display slide numbers, or even the date. This is available to us under Insert. And from there, we have header and footer. Now we could come into this without being in the Slide Master view, but it's a good perspective to think about doing your primary layout work for the formatting and the different elements right here from the Slide Master. So under header and footer, you can see that you could enable date and time. Personally, I don't like to see this because it will be the current system date rather than the date when that presentation may have been delivered. However, you can use this fixed element here if you'd like to display that. And each one of these elements can be moved around. Perhaps you want a footer here. In some organizations, it becomes important to identify if this is, for instance, confidential, or it might be the name of the conference, or simply your organizational name. Slide numbers can also be displayed, and this is something we can show up in our handouts as well. So if we enable that, that also gives us another piece, but in this case, I'll keep that turned off. You can see in this preview that these are some of the positions, and each one of these can be moved around. Notice as well that you have the option not to show this on the title slide, and I'll enable that too. In PowerPoint, one of the other things for you to be watchful of is whether or not you choose apply or apply to all. And here we'll broadly apply this to all of the slides that are in this presentation. Now we have that footer, company confidential, and this then would show at the bottom of each one of these slides. A few changes that we've made, including the logo, the footer, the title. This is also where we can make other changes, such as the appearance of our bullets, the size of the text that's used for the bullets, for instance, and other changes that hopefully improve the readability and the quality of your presentations. Once again, we'll return back to the normal view. Now there's a couple ways to do that. The easiest thing to look at is the Slide Master tab here where you can close. But if you went to View and Normal, that would also take you out of this view. Now let's address here where we might have slides that do not match those choices. So now that you know about the Slide Master and have applied the changes, how can we apply the consistency from one slide to another? If most of the presentations you create and edit are versions of previous ones, you might be thinking that the Slide Master won't work for you because you're really not creating presentations from scratch. Instead, you might be given the presentations with a lot of manual formatting that you're somehow supposed to magically make it look good. One of the reasons editing slides can be such a time suck is because manual formatting overrides the Slide Master formatting. And we also have this challenge that sometimes the corporate or organizational slides are really not based upon the Slide Master. So if you have a template that simply has some sample slides you're supposed to copy, then it might be more challenging to be able to really work with these features. Depending upon how often you use that template, it might be worth digging into and exploring whether or not those examples could actually become part of the Slide Master. So here we have a couple problems, and that is that these are slides that have been manually formatted. And this is really a bad slide. Here's just a change to the title. But how can we fix these so that they will match our preferences in the Slide Master? The first thing is to select one or more slides. And I can do that through Control. And just by holding Control, can click on these. These are the slides I want to apply changes to. You actually could Control A and select all of them if that was an issue. But you may want to do case by case just to see what happens, because it might be much more dramatic than you were expecting. Next, what we will do is simply right click, and here is Reset Slide. Ready? This is the magical part of working with the Slide Master. The slide is reset, including this one that was very, very bad. and this one as well. The other place you can find Reset is in the Home tab and Reset. This is one of my favorite time-saving PowerPoint tips. With just a few clicks, the slides are formatted to match the slide master. Where did it get that information? Once again, let's go to View, Slide Master. As you hover over each of these layouts, one of the things that you'll see here is it says title and content layout used by slides, and you'll see those numbers. That's where it was getting the information to know what to reset to. So this is also something which you can work with once you're familiar with the Slide Master, is to create your own custom layouts, to rename them. For instance, if I right click here, I could insert a brand new Slide Master, insert a new layout, duplicate this layout and make some changes to it, and even rename them so that they might be clearer or more specific to our preferences in them. How can you be more productive, have more fun by working with the Slide Master in PowerPoint? For more time-saving PowerPoint tips and techniques, head to thesoftwarepro.com/PowerPoint. I hope you've learned multiple ways to save time in PowerPoint with the Slide Master. This is Dawn Bjork, the Software Pro. Thanks for watching.